You need to do this one thing before you close your laptop lid every time, whether you're selling your laptop or not, never will, or might in the future. You need to do this one thing. A simple microfiber cloth can greatly extend the life of your MacBook or any laptop really, preventing screen damage and greatly increasing its trade-in value when it's time to upgrade. And I don't mean just cleaning your screen with a microfiber cloth, although that is a good habit to get into. Hi everybody, Fox Nomad here, and today I want to help you travel smarter by showing you why you should put a microfiber cloth on top of your keyboard before you close your laptop lid every single time. See, laptops, especially MacBooks, are designed to be as thin as possible. In the MacBook Air, Pro, and regular MacBooks, the guts of the computer are in the bottom, thicker half. That's because the bottom of the MacBook has to house the battery, the hard drives, the motherboard, all the components that drive what you're going to see on the screen. The screen, on the other hand, is usually a lot thinner because it has less bulky components. Millions of diodes, a camera, and a few light sensors. All components that can be crammed into a space as thin as a couple of millimeters. And we know laptop manufacturers, especially Apple, really want to keep their devices as thin as practically possible. The body of the laptop and the components inside are meticulously designed for optimal placement. Not a single square centimeter is wasted. The fans are placed optimally for cooling, the battery as large as regulations and the chassis will allow, and all of these parts are coordinated to balance power, battery, and heat. With the other flap of your laptop, the screen, Apple is also playing a delicate balance of performance and function. With performance, they want to fit in the best screen they can with the thinnest bezels to give you more screen real estate to look at. The camera and the light sensors in the top are limited by the physical constraints of keeping the screen flap slim. And because of how a screen functions, you have to look at it, there are limitations on how well it can be protected. Now, getting back to the main point about this microfiber cloth, see, we've gone over why laptops are designed to be thin. That means sandwiching components in a flat, practical, powerful computing pancake. But that doesn't leave a lot of space for, well, space. Close your laptop lid and you'll notice the keys can't and won't be too far away from the sensitive screen itself. Apple has put in these rubber bumpers along the edges of the screen to give it a little, like a millimeter of space, but those bumpers are most effective around the edges. You can't reinforce the screen in the middle as easily because you have to, well, look at the screen. When you close your laptop lid on a desk, that tiny space is probably not too big of an issue. But place your MacBook in a backpack where it's more compressed by other things that might be in your bag, especially when you place it flat, the center of the screen is going to be where the pressure could force an ever so slight bending. Enough bending to where that screen could be pushing just on top of the keys of your MacBook. There isn't a lot of margin of error, and the keys touching your screen aren't that big of a deal, at least if it doesn't keep happening over time. But continued key screen contact over time can subtly destroy your screen and knock off a huge chunk of its resale value. That's not only from the keys physically over time imprinting themselves onto your screen, there's another issue. It's your hands. No, look, your hands look lovely. But like every set of hands, they produce sweat and grease and tend to pick up dirt. You might be talking on your phone 1 minute, and next, some of your earwax is on your keyboard. In short, keyboards, even at their best, are gross. Keyboard screen contact is bad because MacBook screens come with an anti-glare coating. When that coating breaks down, it's known as delamination. You might notice your MacBook screen looking something like this. And if you're wondering what causes delamination, you guessed it right. It's keyboard impact on the screen and finger grease. And delamination, as I've learned personally the hard way, can really reduce your MacBook's trade-in value. When you apply online to trade in your MacBook for a new one through Apple's trade-in program, they'll ask you a few basic questions about its age, model, and condition. You'll get an estimate online, and then you ship your old MacBook to one of several companies Apple outsources trade-in inspections to. Screen delaminations aren't always obvious, especially after you use a screen on a daily basis. It could be subtle enough to go unnoticed. Except Apple will notice though, and when they do, usually knock off close to $1,000 on a trade-in. And that could significantly throw off your budget for a new MacBook. So you might be trading it in and expecting $1,500 back, and now you only got $500 back. Sure, you could reject Apple's offer and wait for them to send you the MacBook and then try to sell it on some third-party site. Now you've noticed the delamination because now you can't unsee it, and selling it might be more difficult, might throw off your budget for the new MacBook. It's all a big pain. Screen delamination isn't fixable. It requires a screen replacement, and that is very expensive. Fortunately, preventing screen delamination is pretty straightforward and really cheap. The easiest way to prevent screen delamination is to put a microfiber cloth, one big enough to cover your entire laptop keyboard, just like this, every time before you close the lid. This will keep your screen and the keys separate, even if pressure is applied from a backpack sitting on its side or heat expansion. Try not to use this microfiber cloth for anything else and replace it once a year or more often if you close your laptop lid a lot and pack it in a bag. See, this microfiber cloth will also pick up grease and dirt from your keyboard, and over time you want to just replace it occasionally. A few other things you can do to keep your screen and keyboard in good condition is to use something like iClear. It's what Apple stores use to keep their display machines sparkling, and it will work for you too. Once a week, give your keyboard, trackpad, and screen a good wipe with an electronic cleaner using another microfiber cloth to remove excess grease. If you want to go another step further, wash your hands before sitting down to type to remove grease, sweat, food, and if you're at home, don't close your laptop lid every time you get up from the desk. You might have kids or a cat and need to close that screen every time you get up for protection, but if you don't, it's a good habit to get out of. That can prolong your screen well into its golden years when you might want to trade it in for an upgrade. Also, try not to overpack your backpack when it's carrying your MacBook, and if you do, try to keep your bag vertical when you place it on the ground so most of the weight isn't on the flat part of the laptop. And don't eat over your keyboards. Like, don't, that's just gross, and it's even more gross when your food grease gets on the keyboard, and then now you're closing the laptop screen, and now all that grease from your sandwich is now on your screen. So remember, put a microfiber cloth on your keyboard before you close the laptop lid every single time. Keep your laptop clean, don't mash it into an overstuffed backpack, and be gentle. It doesn't matter what kind of microfiber cloth you use, just make sure it's not too thick, and it can be pretty thin to be effective. If it's too thick, the lid is not going to close properly, but just a thin, regular old microfiber cloth like this one could save you and your trade-in and your laptop screen thousands of dollars. Not a bad investment for something that probably costs a couple bucks at most, so long as you remember to use it. I hope this video saves your laptop screen from a faded and less valuable future, but if you're curious about the Apple trade-in program, I've done a couple of videos about it, so I'll link to those, trading in MacBooks and trading in iPhones. I'll link to those videos down in the description below, and while you're down there, hit the like and subscribe buttons. It really helps the channel. I appreciate it, and I have new videos for you every week, so you want to make sure to subscribe not to miss any of those. Thanks very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.